Hey guys, Varun Marathi here, and in this video I'm going to do the gaming performance of Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. So before I begin, I would like to urge you to please subscribe to my channel so that I'm able to bring you more such videos in the future. So as we all know that Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is the latest device from Samsung, and this version over here is the Exynos variant that I have with me, and it has Mali G76 new GPU. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the most popular and most demanding game which is there right now on mobile application, that is PUBG Mobile. So this is the first time I'm going to play this this game on this device. So let's begin. We'll also be able to check how much time does the game take to load. This is the 8GB RAM variant of Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. So certainly you'll be able to see how fast the GPU is when it is loading the game as well. Right off the back, as you can see, the punch hole display on the top is just enough in the corner that it is not going to affect your gameplay, and the Super AMOLED dynamic display that is there on this device is looking very beautiful, and the minimal bezels are making the experience of looking at this game really good. As you can see, the saturation is amazing, and I won't be able to play very properly because I have to show you on the camera as well, so bear with me. So as you can see over here very clearly, the game looks fabulous on this full screen, and showing you the graphic settings over here, the phone is playing at the top settings that is available, that is HDR and the ultra settings. So definitely it is capable of playing at the highest settings. So let's now begin with the game. And when you start the game, actually it for the very first time it is not going to start in this aspect ratio. The punch hole display, the area which is there will be a black bar, and the game will start from on the other side of that punch hole display. So we'll have to manually make PUBG a full screen app in order to get this view. Now as you can see over here right off the back, the frame rate at which I am able to run over here, as you can see, it's very very smooth, and by my experience we are very easily you know, playing it at around 40-50 FPS, which is really good. And in the future we are going to get the 60 FPS update on this game, and definitely I think S10 Plus will be able to play this game without any issue. And as you can see, everything which is there in the game right now, it is looking very crisp, very beautiful, very detailed. And since it is playing at the highest settings, we can see the individual details very clearly on the road and even on the player. As you can see, the punch hole display does not come in the game as much because more or less we are concentrated on the center of the screen where the character is while playing the game. So definitely that is not going to affect us as much as I thought it would. And other than that, no other element of the game has been cut. So definitely I think the gaming performance on this device will be good. Beginning with the game, I would actually be fast forwarding few parts of the game. Since it's a very long gameplay that I had, I'll be fast forwarding it for some time. And right now I'll just show you how crisp the jump and the movement in the game is. So definitely bear with me. As you can see over here that the phone is having no issues in loading the map of the game very very quickly. As you can see over there, as we are moving towards it, the map is getting loaded very quickly. So definitely I would say the processor on this device is very very powerful, and it is helping in the rendering of the game very very quickly, which is really really important. And I think there's no other game right now which is as demanding as PUBG. So definitely this game will be speaking for all other games which are there on to be played on the mobile device. So as you can see, even though we are in a building, the rendering, the frames per second have not dropped. We are still moving at the very very crisp rate as we are supposed to. So definitely I think the gameplay on this device is going to be really really nice. And also the AMOLED display is providing a very very immersive and brilliant gaming experience on this device. So definitely that is something which is a very very strong point of this device. So now what I'm going to do is now I'm going to fast forward the game a little bit so that you just get to know how where the action is. I was not able to kill a lot many people because it's difficult by this angle. So just I'll just show you how it happened. So bear with me. Okay, so as you can see over here, even the gameplay in the water, the color which is there of the water, it is looking fabulous. The greens, the blues, the saturation level on this device is simply amazing. And combined with the processor, we are getting a very crisp and fast gameplay, which I did not expect from an Android device. Let's see now. Here is where I've seen a person. Let's try shooting him. And okay, there you go. It's the form factor of this device is really different now, because I've been used to playing on Samsung Galaxy Note 9, which is having similar screen, but it is little bit bigger than this phone because of the bezels which are there on the top and the bottom. So while playing on this device, it is feeling a little bit difficult because the dimensions are different. It is smaller, it is more compact to hold, and my muscle memory is actually not allowing me to trigger to actually touch the area where the trigger is supposed to be. I'm still playing as if I'm playing on Samsung Galaxy Note 9. But as you can see over here, it is a really really smooth gameplay, and definitely I think Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is one of the best gaming devices which are there. And it also has the water cooling system which was present on the Note 9 first. And it is a very large copper chamber which is there next to the battery and on the processor, and I think it will help in actually reducing the heat, and it will reduce the throttling that happens due to the heating up of the processor. Definitely this is one of the best gaming devices that you can get, and it has sheer power which is there in this game, and this device is perfectly able to harness the power of the game. So as you can see over here, I just died by killing two people. But still, if we talk about overall gameplay of on this device, the game ran flawlessly, and that is something which is really important to most of you people and even to me. Now I play on Samsung Galaxy Note 9, and it is very similar to what we are seeing over here, because to a layman we are not going to see a lot of difference between the gameplay of two devices. But certainly this device is more immersive. It is a tad bit more smoother because of the newer GPU that we have over here, and it is definitely going to be able to play the Ultra HD, the 60 FPS version of the game, which will be coming in the future very quickly. So all in all guys, this was the video, and I hope you like the video. The unboxing video is also done, and I have also done benchmark. So I'll give thumbs up to this device, and if you like the video guys, please subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up. And I'll see you in my next video. Peace.